Guys, welcome back. This is KC from KC Designs. So we're going to continue from where we left off. So this is the second part of making this design. So today we're going to be making the next design. So I would advise you, if you haven't watched the first part, that you go in and check my channels and then check out the first part of this series. Okay, so today we're going to continue by making this. So since we already have this done already in the first part, so we're not going to repeat this part down here, and then up here is the same thing we've done here before, but up here we're just going to remove some of this and then change the position of the image and then the position of this strip down here. So I'm going to start by making some little arrangements on the text. So let me hold my control key and then click on the text and then just kind of rearrange this business, okay, and space. So I'm just going to take this up here like so, okay. Okay, then kind of increase the scale, control T to go to transform to and increase the scale, and then for my mission statements, holding control and selecting the layers, then I'll just push this downwards a bit more like so, and then for the business, maybe I just need to bring this downwards a bit. Oh, that's fine. Okay. So, next thing I'm going to be doing is I'm going to put this entire design on a single group. So I'm going to click on this top one, scroll down to around the image. I'm still going to leave the background as it is. And then I'll just control G to group. Or you just right click and then go to group from layers. And then let me just name this page one. Okay. So the next thing I'm going to be doing is to duplicate this page. Right click, duplicate group. So I want to keep this my duplicate on this same document, which is the roll up. So I'm going to just name this to page two. Click OK. And then I'm going to turn off the visibility of my page one. Turn that off. So now we only need to make some few modifications to make it look just like this page two that we have here. So the first thing I'm going to do is to deal with the top part. So I'm going to hold control, click on this, turn that off. Hold control, click on this, turn that off also. And likewise for this and this. So that's fine. And the next thing I'm going to do is to, close this group, go back to my reference image, and then, okay, the image seems to be on top, and that's fine. So now, this is what I'm going to do. This image, this shape we drew up here, so control, click on that shape, this shape. I'm going to fix my image inside of that shape. So that's very easy to do. So I'm going to click on my image and then drag this on top of this shape, then reposition my image, control T to go to transform to, control T, okay, and then rescale my image, something like this should work, and then I want to flip my image vertically, that's fine. Kind of make this sit inside the shape. Okay, click enter on my keyboard, and then all I have to do is to clip this image to the next, to the layer below it. So that's very easy to do. All I have to do is to, you can do it in two ways, right click and then use create clipping marks, then you have the image clipped to that shape, or let me undo, control Z, or you hold your alt key and put your mouse in between the image layer and then your shape layer, and then you just hold on, holding alt, and then you just click. That's fine. So So now I'm going to rearrange this. So for my strip is supposed to be down here. So I'm going to go look for my strip. Okay. I'm going to go look for my strip. Let's see. Let's find a layer. I think I should have named things. Okay, I found it. It should be this pattern. That's with the backup. And then this is it. So I'm just going to quickly rename this to strip. Strips, okay. Then I'm going to take this down. Control T. Flip it horizontal. And then put this where it should be. Let's name this my reference image, okay. Yeah, it should be somewhere around there. Then enter on your keyboard. That's fine. So for my text, I'm going to select them. Select my text. Put them in a group. Control G to put them in a group. Name this text contents. Text contents. And then I'm just going to move this. Check my reference image. I'm going to move this somewhere around here. And then open it up, go to my space. Maybe I just move this business headline close to the space so I can easily select them. I move that around here. Move those around here. Then the space should go here, like so. Then my business should be more bolder. Go to my text and turn on this, tick this on. I'm using Mural Pro and then semi-bold. That's fine. Okay, so I have that all fixed. And then let me go back to my reference image, kind of compare. Okay, so my mission statement, maybe I should take down the opacity down a little bit, and same likewise for the rectangle. That's fine. So then for my business, I'm still going to try and make this align properly to the space here. That's fine. So I'm going to save this. Control S to save. Then I want to remove my guides. So that's very easy to do. So go to view and then you click on clear guides. And that's all. So now that we're here, I'm just going to quickly show you guys how to save out an image from Photoshop directly like this. So that's very easy. But do not forget, we're still going to be making the mockup for this. So that will be in the third part. So I'm just going to go to save this out as an image. I'll go to File, Save As, and then from Save As type, choose JPEG, or you choose PNG or TIFF, whichever one you would prefer. So JPEG, then you look for the location where you want to save it to, and then click Save. But for now, I'm not going to be saving this. So that's fine. So now that we're here, I just want to show you guys a little trick. So I have my page one and my page two. So maybe I should just go down here and then just make this bold also. Taking this and change this to semi-regular, semi-bold. That's fine. Then for this, let me take this up here also. And then take down the opacity for this. That's fine. So I'm going to save again. Control S to save. So the trick I'm going to be showing you guys is how to take a screenshot of your entire design on a new layer. So let me quickly show you guys. So I'm going to create a new layer on top, like so, and then I'm going to be holding down some shortcut keys. So I'm going to say it out. Hold down your Control, Shift, Alt, and E. So that will quickly make a screenshot for me. So if I turn off my page one and then my background, I still see my screenshot on a different layer. So that's fine. So I'm going to name this page one. Page one. And I'm going to turn this off. Turn on my page two. Turn on my background. Create a new layer on top of this and then click on the same shortcut keys, Control Alt Shift E. So that's fine. they're taking a screenshot of my entire design on a new layer. So what it does is that it takes a screenshot of your entire design, which is visible on a new layer, as long as you've already created a new layer. So name this to page two. Okay, so I'm going to save this. So in the next lesson, I'm going to be showing you guys how to create a mockup, something very similar to this in Photoshop. So please do make sure you like and subscribe and then share this video also. So I really appreciate that. So thank you guys for watching and then see you guys in the next lesson.